Today in this class, we will learn about the interpretation of color tints used on a topographical survey of India map. So first, let's look at evidence for occupation. The occupation of the people of an area can be inferred from the following things. What are those? Farmer, agriculture. So if you see some yellow wash, so you can say that people are engaged in agriculture and their occupation is farmer or farming. They are farmer or they are doing farming. Forestry, people are engaged in forestry. If you see some green patch around that area. Cattle grazing, you can write when you can see presence of open scrub. Quarrying and mining, if you can see that mines are there, quarries are there, so you can write that. Trade, those settlements near metal road, very dense settlement, connected by roadways, connected by railways. So you can write trade. So let's look at that first one. Suppose if question comes like for Jegol, what is the major occupation of the people living in the area? Give reason for your answer. So around Jegol, we can see that lots of this yellow wash, that means their agriculture is the main occupation of the people, and it is again inferred by number of blue dots, that is perennial lined well, which is helping in the irrigation. So how you'll write the answer? The main occupation of the people living in the area is agriculture, or living in Jegol is agriculture. It is indicated in the map by the yellow wash that covers almost the entire map extra. The presence of a large number of perennial line dwell also support this inference. Next, let's look at this. Mention any one occupation of the people living in Sakura. Where is Sakura? Sakura is here in the middle of this forest. So give reason for your answer. So always remember, when in topo sheet you are saying something, you are giving an answer and you have to reason, give reason for this. Inferred something from the map and you have to support your answer. The people living in Sakura might be engaged in forestry because of the presence of dense mixed jungle around them. Some people living in Sakura might be engaged in agriculture, indicated in the map by the yellow wash that cover some portion in the map extract. So these two. So here we can see that dense mixed jungle here and dense mixed jungle here. And fairly dense mixed jungle here. So this says that dense mixed jungle means it is deciduous trees. So deciduous tree, we know that it is easy to do forestry in that area. What is the major occupation of the people living in Idaria? Where is Idaria? Here it is in the center. So we can see mostly around Idaria, it is white barren land. And open scrub is there. So in this case, you can say the main occupation of the people living in Idaria is cattle rearing, or you can say animal rearing or goat rearing, you can write. So it is indicated in the map by the presence of open scrub. Open scrub. Next, mention any occupation of the people living in Chitraseni is engaged in. Okay. So in Chitraseni is here, we can see that it is very well connected. This is the metal road is here. Here is a metal road. Another metal road going from this side. Then there is this railway line is also here. It is very, very well connected. Okay. Even we can see railway station is here. There is a post office. Okay. So here you can write that one of the occupation the people living in Chitraseni is engaged in can be trading. It is indicated in the map as Chitraseni is well connected by metal road and railways. Let's look at this. Mention any occupation the people living in Panswala is engaged in. Where is Panswala? Panswala is here. What is there around this? We can see one lime kiln is here, another lime kiln is that side. So you can write in this case one of the occupation the people living in Panswala is employed in lime kiln, and it is indicated in the map by the presence of lime kiln. There are two kiln we can see here. Even you can write the people might be engaged in agriculture because we can see lots of yellow wash. Please don't write fishing. Because such a small, thin stream cannot support a family throughout the year. So never ever ride fishing when it is next to a very small, thin line in the river. Next, mention any occupation the people living in Marol is engaged in. So here is Marol. We can see one that is fair, that monthly fair is there. So as such, you can write about the agriculture. See here also, it is yellow wash is there. Number of perennial wells are there. So you can write that. And also you can write people might be engaged in cottage industry. So people living in Marol might be engaged in cottage industry. This is indicated in the map by the presence of fair. So that's monthly fair is there. And where a large variety of handmade artifacts manufactured by members of the household in the rural settlement will be sold. You are giving answer and then giving explanation for your inference. Mention any occupation the people living in Dantrai is engaged in. See, in Dantrai, we can see here, post office is there, police chowki is there, and there are, so you can write this answer like that. Many people in Dantrai will be employed in different government departments like post office marked with symbol PO and police chowki. We have learned that there are different types of occupation, how you can answer that. So let's do a quick revision. So if you can see yellow wash, we'll say farmer. Forestry, green patches there, say forestry. Open scrub is there, cattle grazing. And mines and quarries, though limestone beds are there, quarrying, mining. And if there, it is having dense settlement connected by road and railways, you can say trade. And please be careful with this, that you have to write answer in proper points. So first point, you will identify something. Second point, you will be giving explanation for your understanding. What is the mode of irrigation is used in the area? Give reason for your answer. So we can see Jegol is here. Around Jegol, this is yellow and a yellow wash in this area, and there are number of perennial wells. So well irrigation is the most widespread mode of irrigation in the map extract. This is because of the presence of large number of perennial wells, which have a supply of water throughout the year. Well are indicated by blue dots on the map. Blue dot means perennial well. Next question. Why the word brackish is written next to the well? Where is brackish? Here we can see this place also. We can see brackish. What does it mean? So the line perennial well with brackish water means the water is salty and is unfit for drinking. This you gave your answer. Now how you'll support it? As the region is very arid in nature, due to extreme heat, excessive evaporation takes place, leaving high mineral content in the water. Let's look at different colors now. White, barren land. This area we can see here, this white. So this is barren land. Yellow, these are all yellow. This is agricultural land. Green, this all green areas are forested land. Blue, perennial water bodies, here it is. And brown, contour line, already we have learned about the contour line before. And red, settlement, road, milestone, all these are written with the red color. Abu is a big Mount Abu. Abu means Mount Abu. It's a big settlement. So you can see how big that settlement is.